بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، أخذنا في الدرس الماضي القسم الخامس وهو الرد على من يقول أن الشرك لا يقع في الأمة أو في الجزيرة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه أجمعين. وبعد، then in the last lesson we studied the fifth section of this book كتاب التوحيد, and it is a refutation against the doubt that shirk does not occur in this ummah.
تقدم وأترك الدفاتر. إخوانا إحنا اتفقنا تترك الدفاتر أغلق. أي نعم. وذكرنا في الرد على هذه الشبهة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صرح بوقوع عبادة الأصنام والأوثان في الجزيرة. نعم.
We mentioned as a refutation of this doubt, the doubt i.e. that shirk will not occur in this ummah after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, he mentioned clearly how idols will be worshipped in the Arabian Peninsula.
وكذلك قتال الصحابة المرتدين في الجزيرة العربية.
And also how the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they fought against those people who left Islam after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Arabian Peninsula.
وما الذي يفرق بين وقوع الشرك في الجزيرة وخارج الجزيرة لو كان بمتر واحد مثلا؟
And what is it that differentiates between shirk occurring within the Arabian Peninsula and shirk not occurring within the Arabian Peninsula and shirk occurring outside the Arabian Peninsula? If it's a difference of a meter, what's the difference?
كذلك ذكرنا أن العلماء رحمه الله تعالى في كل مذهب من المذاهب الأربعة يذكر أشياء يكون بها الإنسان نسأل الله عافية والسلام مرتد حتى لو كان في الجزيرة. نعم.
And also we mentioned that the four imams and all of the imams, the scholars, they have mentioned in their books the rulings of those people who are murtad, those who leave Islam after being Muslims. And this is whether it is inside the Arabian Peninsula or out of it.
ثم المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى شرع في القسم السادس على ما قسمنا.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he started the sixth section of كتاب التوحيد as we divided it into the ten sections.
ذكرنا فيه أن المؤلف ذكر في هذا الباب السحر.
And in this section we mentioned that the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned magic.
وعلاقة السحر بالتوحيد أن الساحر يدعو الناس إلى الشرك بالله ويعبد الناس للشياطين.
And what is the relationship between magic, السحر and التوحيد? We mentioned that the magician, he himself has to worship the shayateen. And also he wants to take the people to the slavery and to the worship of the shayateen.
وعلامات يعرف بها الساحر.
And we also studied the various indicators or signs showing us that somebody is a magician. An example of the indicators, the signs of a person being a magician is he doesn't fulfill one of the conditions that we mentioned of ruqya. And also that he ties knots and he spits or blows on these knots. He writes individual letters of the alphabet on a piece of paper. Nobody writes, just pay attention. And also looking at the stars, i.e. astronomy. Signs and indicators of a magician is that he comes and he orders the people with that which opposes the Sharia.
أنه في العصر الحاضر تنوعت طرق السحر وتنوعت طرق الوصول إلى السحر بما هو يعني سهل جدا.
And we also mentioned how now in the modern time today how the avenues and the types of magic are so many and how it is so easy for people to reach the magician and also easy for the magician to reach the people.
وذكرنا أن الإتيان لهم يكون بالمجالسة أو بالاتصال أو بالنظر في الجرائد والمجلات التي في أبراج.
And we mentioned that interacting with these magicians can occur through a person sitting with them, or through the mobile phone, or even reading newspapers and journals and magazines.
وأن الإتيان لهم إذا أتى إليهم لا تقبل له صلاة 40 يوم أو نظر في قنوات أو كذا.
And we mentioned that a person who approaches a magician or sends a text message, for example, or reads those magazines or those journals, then just by him reading or looking or listening to them, then that person's prayer isn't accepted for 40 days.
ولو صدق كفر بما أنزل على وإذا صدق كفر بما أنزل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then if a person believes in what the magician has said or what has been written in the journals and the magazines and the newspapers, like the horoscopes the Sheikh mentioned yesterday, then this person, he has disbelieved in that which was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we mentioned that sometimes a person might not believe that which he has read or what the magician has said straight away, but possibly after a few days he begins to believe it.
نعم. وذكرنا أن السحر إذا وقع لابد من علاج. والعلاج قلنا ينقسم إلى قسمين. نعم.
And we said that if magic occurs or if somebody is afflicted with magic, then you have to cure him or find the cure. And this cure, this علاج, it is of two types.
مشروع وممنوع.
That which is legislated and Islamically correct, and that which is impermissible.
المشروع يكون بالرقية الشرعية بشروطها.
So the legislated form of cure of magic is either it is done through the Islamic ruqya, i.e. Islamic incantations and recitations,
وبالدعاء,
and also through supplications,
والأدوى المباحة,
and also the medicine which is permissible.
أو يكون بالسحر.
And then the other type of cure is, which is impermissible, is curing magic with magic.
وهذا ذكرنا أنه لو وجد أحد من العلماء من يقول أنه يصح حل السحر بسحر نرد عليهم بأمور.
And we said that even if there was a scholar who said that it is permitted for a person to cure magic with magic, then we reply to him with a number of ways.
مخالف للكتاب.
Number one, that this statement of the permissibility of curing magic with magic is in opposition to the Book of Allah.
والسنة.
And also the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وقال السلف.
And also the statements of the Salaf.
وتضعيف للتداب القرآن.
And also in it is a weakening of a person using the Quran as a cure.
تقوية للسحر.
And also in it is strengthening the magicians themselves.
والعلاج بالسحر مظنون.
And also we mentioned how curing magic with magic is just a possibility. It's a possibility somebody might be cured.
والعلاج بالقرآن يقين.
And as for making ilaj or using the Quran as a cure, then we know that this is something which is certain.
ويصنع له سحر جديد.
And then also, in trying to cure that magic, the other magician, he comes up with another magic now.
ولا يمكن أن يقدم الساحر الثاني شيء للمريض إلا بأن يقدم شيء للشيطان.
And also, that this second magician now, he similarly cannot come with any type of magic except that he has now gone and worship shaitan or tries to please shaitan.
وَلَوْ صَبَرَ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ.
And if this person who has been afflicted by magic, if he was to remain patient, then for him is paradise.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا ذكرنا ما يتعلق بالتطير.
And then after this, we mentioned that which is linked to التطير, i.e. seeing bad omens or being very pessimistic.
وذكرنا الفرق بين الفأل والتطير.
And we mentioned the difference between الفأل, which is, you know, being optimistic.
الفعل هو الكلمة الطيبة.
الفعل, which is having, making good statements or having a good approach.
والتطير هو التشاؤم بمرئي أو مسموع أو أزمنة أو أمكنة.
And as for التطير, then it is pessimism or seeing a bad omen is something which can be seen or something which is مرئي
أو مسموع
or something which is heard
أو أزمنة أو أمكنة
or certain times and certain places.
الفعل مستحب.
So الفعل, saying good words, having a good approach and having optimism, this is something which is recommended.
والتطير شرك أصغر.
And as for التطير, then this is a minor form of shirk.
الفعل حال الموحد.
And al-fa'al, again the same meaning, then this is the way of a person of tawheed.
والتطير حال المشرك والمنافق.
And as for التطير, then this is the situation of a person of shirk and a person of nifaq, hypocrisy.
الفعل حسن ظن بالله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in a person having a good approach or a positive approach, being optimistic in this is a person having a good thought of Allah.
والتطير سوء ظن بالله سبحانه وتعالى.
And as for seeing bad omens and being pessimistic, then in this is su'adhan, having an evil suspicion or a bad thought about Allah.
الفعل يعطي القلب انشراح والتطير انقباض في الصدر
وضيق. And الفعل, this gives a person tranquility in one's heart, opens his mind and his chest. As for التطير, bad omens and pessimism, then this restricts the mind of a person.
الفعل لا يجعلك تمضي ولا ترجع, لكن التطير يجعلك تمضي أو ترجع.
And as for al-fa'al, i.e. having a positive and good approach, then this doesn't affect whether you do something or you don't do something which is specific. As for seeing a bad omen or having a pessimistic approach due to seeing something or hearing something, then this makes you decide whether you should do that thing or you shouldn't do that thing. What the hell?
يعني الآن هو متردد هل يتزوج أو لا يتزوج.
So as an example to make it clear, there's a person and he's hesitant, unsure, should he marry a particular woman or not marry a particular woman.
فماذا يصنع؟
So what does he do?
يدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى.
He should supplicate to Allah.
أما أنه يأخذ وردة مثلا ويقطعها تزوج أو لا تزوج.
As for a person, he takes a rose or a flower and he says, I'm marry her, I don't marry her. I marry her, I don't marry her.
أو يذكر بعض الأعداد.
Or he starts mentioning certain numbers.
أو يفتح المصحف.
Or a person, he opens the Mus'haf.
هذا تطير بالقرآن.
A person, he opens a mushaf, and if his sight falls on an ayah of mercy, for example, he says, I'm going to marry her. If his eyesight falls on an ayah of punishment, he says, I'm not going to marry her. Then this is at-tatayyur, this is using the Qur'an as a bad omen.
لا يمضي ولا يرجع إلا لأمر شرع مشروع أو أمر محسوس.
So a person should not decide to do something or not to do something except due to a reason which is legislated in the Sharia, or another physical reason which is mahsus, physical, which is something which can be seen or sensed.
يعني مثلا الآن عندما كان متردد بين الزواج وعدم الزواج, يعني الولي طلب منه أشياء محرمة, فقال أنا ما أمضي في هذا النكاح والحمد لله رب العالمين, هذا سبب شرعي.
As an example, this person who was hesitant or was unsure whether to marry this woman or not to marry her, when the guardian of this woman, he said, if you want to marry this woman, you need to do this, this and this, and this is all muharram, like music and dancing and so on and so forth. Then he said, you know, I don't need to marry her, alhamdulillah, I don't want to do these things. So this is now a Islamically legislated reason for a person not to take this decision to marry her.
أو سبب حسي محسوس.
Or another reason, which is something which is physical and real.
أراد السفر.
An example, a person wants to travel somewhere.
وصل إلى المطار.
And he gets to the airport.
وقالوا تأجلت الرحلة إلى يومين مثلا.
And in the airport they say that this flight has been delayed for 2 days.
هذا سبب محسوس, ماذا يصنع؟ يبقى والحمد لله.
So this is now a physical reason. What can he do? He has to not remain behind.
أما أراد السفر مثلا ووصل إلى المطار ووجد رجل أعمى أو أعرج أو كذا, قال لا ما أسافر في هذا اليوم.
As for a situation whereby a person wants to travel, he gets to the airport and he sees a blind person, for example, or he sees a person with a particular disability, and because of this he says, I don't want to travel today.
هذا هو التطير.
Then this is التطير, seeing bad omens.
طيب ثم بعد هذا ذكر ما يتعلق بعلم النجوم.
And then after this the author رحمه الله, he mentioned that which relates to astronomy.
علم النجوم ينقسم إلى قسمين.
So this type of science, i.e. astronomy, then it is two types.
علم تسيير, يعني يستدل بالنجوم على الجهات وأوقات الزرع وفصول السنة.
So one
علم جائز.
So one aspect of astronomy is what they call التسيير, i.e. a person uses the stars to calculate certain seasons or certain times or certain directions, and this is something which is permitted.
يستدل بالنجوم على الجهاد.
So a person uses the stars for as a direction.
الشمال والجنوب.
To determine certain directions, north or south.
وأوقات الزرع.
And also the times for cultivating and farming.
وفصول السنة. فصول السنة.
And also
الربيع والشتاء والصيف وكذا.
And also using the stars to know the seasons of the year, summer, winter, so on and so forth.
أو جهة القبلة.
And also a person using the stars to know the direction of the Qibla.
هذا جائز والجهة القبلة واجب لأنه يؤدي إلى واجب. إذن هذا تعلم صحيح. نعم.
So this is something which is permitted, and in terms of using the stars to determine the Qibla, then this is something which is an obligation, because knowing the Qibla is an obligation. And therefore, learning this type of science in relation to astronomy, this is something which is permitted.
القسم الثاني,
the second type,
من تعلم علم النجوم أن يستدل بالنجوم على ما يقع في الأرض.
So the second type of astronomy is using the stars to try to determine that which is going to happen in the earth.
يعني يقول طلع هذا النجم يموت فلان.
So a person says that this star has appeared, so this person is going to die.
ينتصر أهل الإسلام على أهل الكفر في هذه الأيام. يقول ينتصر يحصل نصر في هذه الأيام.
So a person, he sees a particular star and he says, for example, that the Muslims on this day, because of this star, are going to become victorious over the non-Muslims, as an example.
أين اعتقد أن النجم هو المؤثر بذاته فهذا الشرك أكبر.
So if a person believes that it is the star itself which is causing this victory, or it is influencing the decision itself, then this is shirk akbar, a major form of shirk, and indeed the fall of Islam.
وإذا اعتقد أن سبب والله سبحانه وتعالى لم يجعلها أسباب.
And as for if he believes that this star is a means which Allah has made as a means, and this is shirk asghar, because Allah has not placed it as a means.
نعم. إذا مرة أخرى علم النجوم ينقسم إلى قسمين.
So one more time, astronomy or the knowledge of the science of stars is two types.
مشروع وممنوع.
That which is legislated and permitted, and that which is forbidden.
المشروع إما جائز أو واجب.
So that which is Islamically legislated is either permissible or an obligation.
والثاني إما شرك أكبر أو شرك أصغر.
And then the second type, which is forbidden, is either شرك أصغر, a minor form of shirk, or a major form of shirk.
مما كان عليه أهل الجاهلية أنهم كانوا يطلبون من النجم إنزال المطر.
From the actions of the people of Jahiliyyah, the things that they were accustomed to doing is that they used to seek rain from a particular star.
وكذلك من العلامات التي يعرف بها الساحر النظر في النجوم, لأنه ينظر في النجوم ويعتقد أن لها تأثير فيما يحدث في هذه الأرض.
And also from the indicators or the signs that we can use to know that a person is a magician is him looking into the stars, because a magician often looks into the stars in order to determine whether things are going to happen in this earth or not.
ثم بعد هذا جاء المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بالقسم السابع.
And after this chapter, then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he came with the seventh section of the book Kitab al-Tawheed.
لديهم كتاب كتاب لديك أعطنا كتاب جزاك الله جيد.
هذا الذي يخص منه القلم
مع القلم خلي نحتاج القلم. نعم. إذن هذا هو القسم السابع.
ما قسم
نعم.
قسم السابع شو؟
هذا هو القسم السابع أعمال القلوب.
So therefore the seventh section of Kitab al-Tawheed are the actions of the heart.
من أعمال القلوب المحبة.
From the actions of the heart is محبة, loving, love.
أخذنا فيما تقدم
So we have mentioned or studied in that which has come previously.
المحبة أنها تنقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
That محبة, love, we can divide it into three categories.
من يعرف؟
Who remembers?
نعم. الأول,
the first category,
محبة مع الله.
محبة مساوية لمحبة الله. حكم هذه المحبة.
So the first category, as the brother mentioned, Jazalah Khair, is a person loving something equal to the love of Allah. And the ruling of it is Shirk Akbar.
الثاني محبة في الله أو لله هذه واجبة من أوثق عرى الإيمان.
And then the second type is, the second category is loving for the sake of Allah. And this is, the ruling is it is an obligation and it is the foremost aspects of Iman.
للعمل والعامل والأزمنة والأمكنة.
And we mentioned that a person has to love actions and people and play and times and places.
الثالث
محبة طبيعية.
محبة طبيعية. وحكم هذه المحبة
جائز.
نعم الله يفتح عليك. نعم.
And then the third category is a type of love which is natural and intrinsic to every human being. And the ruling of this type of love is that it is permissible.
بشرط ألا يقدم هذه المحبة على محبة الله إنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة.
With the condition that this type of love is not given preference over the love of Allah. As Allah said in the Quran, indeed, your property and your children are a fitna.
ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في هذا الباب.
The author, رحمه الله, he mentioned in this section,
محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Or he mentioned in this chapter, the love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لابد أن يكون النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب إليك من كل مخلوق. نعم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he has to be the most beloved person to you from all of creation.
ولا يمكن أن تكون محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مثل محبة الله سبحانه وتعالى ومساوية.
But at the same time, then the love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم cannot be more than the love of Allah or equal to the love of Allah.
لماذا نحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ لماذا؟
Why do we love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
لأنه رسول الله.
Because he's the messenger of Allah.
وإذا كان الله سبحانه وتعالى أحب إليك من كل شيء لابد أن يكون النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب إليك من كل مخلوق.
And if Allah سبحانه وتعالى he is more beloved to you than anything else, then similarly the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has to be more beloved to you than any other creation.
لما قام به عليه الصلاة والسلام من بذله غاية الجهد في تبليغ هذا الدين.
And also the second reason why we love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم due to the amount of effort and the striving that he placed in conveying and transmitting this religion.
لما أتى الله سبحانه وتعالى من حسن الخلق.
And also the good manners and the good characteristics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
ثم أن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام هو سبب جعل الله سبحانه وتعالى سببا بأن كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كل خير يلحق بنا فالنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام سبب في هذا.
And also another reason is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a reason for every good action or every good that happens to us and occurs with us, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a cause for this. So these are the reasons for loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
كيف نحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
How should we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
قد يأتيك إنسان ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مات.
A person might come to you and say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has died, he's passed away.
كيف نحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد مات؟
And how do we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he has passed away?
كيف؟
How?
اتباع. أولا بتعلم السنة.
Firstly, by learning and studying the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
لأن هناك من يدعي محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو كاذب في الدعاء.
Because there exist some people who claim love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, however he is lying and false in his love of the Prophet, in his claiming of the love of the Prophet.
لأنه ينشر البدع.
Because this person he spreads the innovations.
محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تكون أولا بتعلم السنة.
So the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is firstly in learning and studying his sunnah.
الثاني بالعمل بها.
And then secondly, implementing and acting upon his sunnah.
وهذا أيضا تجد بعض الناس يقول أنا محب للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا يظهر عليه أثر اتباع سنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And just like this, you find many people saying they love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and yet you don't see any effect of him implementing the sunnah upon his appearance.
ثم بالدعوة إلى سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then the other way to love the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is to call to his sunnah.
وبالدفاع عن سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And also in defending the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا هو الحب الحقيقي لسنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So this is the true real love of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
طيب ثم بعد هذا ذكر بعد المحبة ذكر الخوف.
And then after this, after mentioning محبة love, the author he mentioned خوف fear.
لأن السائر إلى الله العبد عندما يسير إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى لابد أن يجمع في سير إلى الله بين الخوف والرجاء. نعم.
And this is because a servant or a worship of Allah, when he's traversing the path to Allah, he has to combine between two things, between love and between fear.
يعني دائما يخاف من ذنوبه.
Meaning, a person, he's always fearful and scared over his sins.
كأن الذنوب جبل يكاد يسقط عليه على رأسه.
His feeling is as if his sins are a mountain that is about to collapse over his head.
ومع هذا لا يقنط من رحمة الله.
And yet, at the same time, then he doesn't become despondent and lose hope in the mercy of Allah.
فالخوف ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
So, الخوف, fear, it is divided into three categories.
الأول خوف عبادة وتعظيم وسر يجب صرفه لله. من صرف هذا الخوف لغير الله فمشرك شرك أكبر. خوف عبادة وتعظيم لله لا لغيره وسر يعني في إذا كان وحده ما يصنع أي شيء لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يعلم السر وأخفى.
So the first type of الخوف fear is a type of fear which is an act of worship, and it is done due to exalting and honoring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is done in private just as it is done in public, such that if a person is on his own and nobody can see him, he doesn't sin because he fears Allah. So this type of fear, it is an obligation and it is worship, and therefore directing it to other than Allah, it is shirk al-akbar.
الثاني خوف محرم.
And then the second type of khawf, fear, is that which is impermissible.
خلي هذا يعطينا إن شاء الله. نعم. جزاك الله خير. الثاني خوف محرم.
And then the second type of fear is muharram, that which is impermissible.
Jazakallah. ممنوع شرب الشاي والطعام في الدرس في الجامعة تصنع هذا؟
The Sheikh said it's impermissible or it's forbidden for a person to eat or drink in a lesson in the dars. Will you do this at university?
في مجالس الملوك الرؤساء في اجتماعات الآن الرؤساء والملوك اجتماعات يصنع هذا.
When the people are sitting with the leaders and the kings and the political rulers, do they do this?
يأتي بالسندويش.
He brings his own sandwich.
والبيبسي.
And Pepsi.
سبحان الله. لو دخل كافر الآن هنا يقول هذا ليس بدرس.
If a non-Muslim was to enter now, he would say this isn't a lesson.
هذه حفلة.
This is a celebration or a festival.
صحيح. أي نعم. طيب. إذن الأول من أنواع الخوف صرفه لغير الله شرك أكبر.
So we said that the first type of fear, that which is worship, to direct it to other than Allah, it is shirk أكبر.
الثاني خوف وخوف محرم خوف محرم.
And then the second type of fear is that which is forbidden and impermissible.
وهو الخوف الذي يؤدي إلى طاعة المخلوق في معصية الخالق.
And it is the type of fear which makes you obey the creation in disobedience to Allah.
يعني قال لك والدك.
Meaning, your father said to you,
اليوم ما تصلي الظهر مع الجماعة.
The father, your father said to you today, I don't want you to pray ظهر with in congregation.
تخاف منه.
Do you fear him?
خوف محرم.
This fear is now impermissible.
لا طاعة للمخلوق في معصية الخالق.
There is no obedience to the creation in disobedience to Allah.
أو الخوف المؤدي إلى القنوط من رحمة الله.
And also in this category is the type of fear which leads a person to become despondent and lose hope in the mercy of Allah.
يعني الآن يلبس الشيطان على بعض الناس.
So now Shaitan comes and he deceives certain people.
ويقول لهذا مثلاً.
And he says to this person, for example.
يقول أنت الآن ما شاء الله في المسجد تتظاهر بالتقوى والصلاح والصلاة وطلب العلم.
And he says, and he whispers to this person, that you now in the masjid, you're showing the outward appearance of prayer and knowledge and righteousness.
وتذكر قبل دقائق صنعت ذنب كذا وذنب كذا وذنب كذا.
And you remember how only a few minutes ago you committed this sin and this sin and this sin.
وسوف نصنعنا أنت بعد الدرس كذا وكذا وكذا.
And also after the lesson, me and you, either Shaitan, this person, we're going to do this and this.
فيقول هذا يعني طيب ماذا أصنع؟
So then this person says, okay, what should I do?
قال اترك العبادات كلها. واجعلها كلها محرمات فيقنط من رحمة الله.
And then the Shaitan says to this person that leave all of worship, leave the worship, and this person loses hope in the mercy of Allah.
في الأول كان لديه طاعات ومعاصي إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات.
So previously this person he had good deeds and he had bad deeds, and the good deeds they wipe away the bad deeds.
وخوف الشيطان من رحمة الله وكان كل شيء معاصي نسأل الله عافية السلامة بعد هذا إذا أطاع الشيطان وخاف منه. نعم.
And then Shaitan came to this person and he made him fearful of the mercy of Allah, and now he only has bad sins if he obeys Shaitan.
الخوف الثالث.
And then the third type of fear.
خوف طبيعي جبلي لا يلام عليه الإنسان.
Is a natural, intrinsic type of fear which is natural to every human being, and nobody's blamed for this.
الخوف من اللصوص.
For example, being scared of thieves.
قطاع الطرق.
Bandits or highway robbers.
الخوف من السباع من الأسد من الكلب.
A person being scared or frightened of a predator, lion.
الخوف من النار.
A person being scared of a fire.
هذا خوف طبيعي.
So this is a natural type of fear.
إذن.
And therefore.
الخوف ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
الخوف, fear, it is of three types.
صرف لغير الله شرك أكبر. هذا الأول.
A type of fear that if you were to direct it to other than Allah, then this is shirk akbar.
الثاني خوف محرم. قنوط من رحمة الله وطاعة المخلوق في معصية الخالق.
And then the second type of fear is that which is impermissible, and that is either losing hope and becoming despondent of the mercy of Allah, or the fear which leads you to obey creation in disobedience to Allah.
الثالث خوف طبيعي.
And then the third type of fear is that which is natural and human.
ما حكم الخوف من الجن؟
What is the ruling of a person fearing the jinn?
من يعرف؟
Who knows?
لو جاء علينا إنسان وقال أنا أخاف من الجن.
If a person came to us and he said, I fear the jinn.
من يعرف؟
Who knows?
سبحان الله. سؤال سهل جدا. نعطيهم جوائز لعلنا نأجل. آيفون. تعرف؟ أوقف. ما حكم الخوف من الجن؟
هذا عربي.
عربي؟
لا.
نعم. ما حكم الخوف من الجن؟
What's the ruling of fearing jinn, being scared of jinn?
تخاف من الجن أم لا؟
Are you scared of the jinn or not?
أبد. ولا في وقت.
Never. Not even a single instant.
No, before, but.
من قبل.
أجلس. من يعرف ما حكم الخوف من الجن؟
So who knows the ruling of fearing the jinn?
خوف طبيعي.
بارك الله فيك. خطأ. لا لا ابقى واقف.
He said it is a natural type of fear and this is wrong.
نعم.
نعم. يعني حسب الخوف هي.
الله يفتح عليك.
The brother said according to his type of fear. Mean that there's some detail in this.
تخاف من الجن؟ قال نعم أخاف من الجن. ماذا تصنع؟ قال أذبح لهم وأستعيذ بهم.
So we asked this person, do you fear the jinn? He says, yes, I fear the jinn. We said, what did you do? He said, I sacrificed an animal and sacrificed it for the jinn.
هذا شرك أكبر.
This is now شرك أكبر.
تخاف من الجن؟ الآخر. تخاف من الجن؟ قال نعم أخاف.
Another person, he's also scared of the jinn.
ماذا تصنع؟
What do you do?
أقرأ آية الكرسي.
I recite آية الكرسي.
أقول أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات.
I say أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات.
من شر ما خلق.
شر ما خلق.
أو قال لا أنام وحدي.
نعم.
لا ينام في البيت وحده.
Oh, he says no. I fear the jinn, and because of this, I don't sleep alone in my house.
هذا خوف. طبيعي.
So this is the natural type of fear.
نعم. الله يفتح عليك. طيب. ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى يقول.
ابن القيم may Allah have mercy upon him. He said.
أن كل من قدم محبة شيء. على محبة الله عذبه الله به.
Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, whoever gives preference, the love of somebody else besides Allah, and gives it preference over the love of Allah, then Allah will use this love and make it a cause of punishment for him.
قارون قدم محبة المال على محبة الله.
So قارون, he preferred the love of wealth over the love of Allah.
عذبه الله سبحانه وتعالى بماله.
And then Allah punished him because of his wealth.
فرعون قدم محبة السلطان على محبة الله.
فرعون, the Pharaoh, he preferred his love of authority and rule over his love of Allah.
عذب بسلطانه وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحته جعلها الله سبحانه وتعالى تجري من فوقه.
And Pharaoh was punished because of this love of his authority. Those rivers, they should flow beneath his feet. He was punished by them flowing over him.
وكل من قدم خوفه من شيء على خوفه من الله خوفه الله به.
And every person who gives preference for his fear of something other than Allah over his fear of Allah, then Allah uses this to frighten him.
وأنه كان رجال من الإنس يعوذون برجال من الجن. ما النتيجة؟ زادوهم رهقا أي ازدادوا خوفا على خوفهم.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran in Surah Al-Jinn that there were men amongst the humans and they used to seek refuge in men amongst the jinn or males amongst the jinn. And what was the conclusion or the result of this? Allah said in the Quran فزادهم رهقا. فزادهم رهقا. That those jinn, they only made those men become even more fearful.
طيب. بعد هذا ذكر لنا الشيخ رحمه الله تعالى ما يتعلق بالتوكل.
And then after this, the Sheikh, أي شيخ محمد بن عبد الوهاب, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned that which is relating to التوكل, reliance.
ما هو التوكل؟
So what is التوكل؟
هو صدق الاعتماد على الله, أن تكون صادق في الاعتماد على الله.
It is that a person is truthful in his reliance upon Allah.
واثق بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى منجز لك ما وعد.
And a person trusts and believes that Allah will fulfill that which has been promised, that which He has promised this person.
مع الأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة على الممنوعة.
And at the same time, a person taking those means and those measures which are permitted are not haram.
إذن ثلاثة أشياء لابد أن تكون في التوكل.
And therefore, in التوكل, a person has to fulfill three things.
صدق اعتماد على الله,
which is the truthful reliance upon Allah.
مع الثقة به,
and trusting and believing in Him.
والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة على الممنوعة.
And then, doing those means and measures which are permitted and not impermissible.
مثال.
An example of this is.
يا أخوانا عندما تسهروا في الليل تنام في الدرس. فعندما ننتهي من الدرس أو ينتهي الشيخ من الدرس يعني الأصل ما أحد يتكلم في المسجد أو اجتماعات أو حديث أو كذا، هذا يؤدي إلى ضياع الدروس الآن، كل واحد ينعس الآن هنا في الدرس. نعم.
The Sheikh said that when you're staying awake at night, then that means now you're sleeping in the lesson. Once the lesson is finished, or once the Sheikh, Sheikh Fly Ismail at night, he finishes his lesson, then straight away go to sleep. This is now wasting time in the lesson that every person is nodding away.
جماعة المسجد الأصل أنها تحاسب من يتكلم يعني وقت انتهاء الدروس، ما أحد يتكلم. تريد تتكلم في الجوال أو تجتمع، أخرج خارج المسجد. حتى ارتاح الطلاب، إذا ارتاح الطلاب ما ينام الآن في الدرس، هذا يعني يخفر وهذا بجانب ويخفر سبحان الله. إحنا تكون الدرس قم وقم ما يصلح هذا، ما السبب؟ السبب السهر. نعم.
The Sheikh said that the people who are in charge of the masjid or in charge of this of the conference, they need to be careful and control this. If somebody wants to talk on the phone or talk with his colleagues whilst others are trying to sleep, then he can go out and he can talk over there. As for a person staying awake at night and then sleeping in the lesson, then the reason of this is staying awake at night or speaking after Isha.
كم بقى على الأذان؟ 5 دقائق؟ ما في إشكال، 5 أو 7 لا إشكال. طيب بعد الصلاة إن شاء الله تعالى نكمل باب التوكل. يا أخواننا الذي فيه نعاس الآن يذهب ويتوضأ وكذا، يتنشط قليلا أو يشرب الشاي الآن لا إشكال. نعم. والله أعلم، صلى الله على النبي محمد وعلى آله.
So we have a break now until after the prayer. Whoever wants to go and is feeling drowsy, go have some tea, wash your face, and then come back after the prayer.